Today, once again, I'm coming to you from Country Classic Cars here in Staunton, Illinois. And I thought you might like a look at this 1947 Chevrolet two-door sedan. This one's a bit of a street rod, so I thought we'd take a closer look at it. You can notice right away it's riding on some aftermarket aluminum wheels, some nice slotted mags there. Nice looking chrome bumper out front. Grill's looking pretty slick. It's got a set of tri-bar headlamps in it. Then they've painted the trim around the headlights. Everything's smoothed out. You know, not a lot of badging or trim or anything on this one. There is the one Fleetmaster badge right here. Hey, the car's a bit dusty at the moment, but I think it would clean up pretty nicely. Nice split windshield on this one. And the glass looks to be in really nice shape. Little hot rod peep style mirror. It's a pretty sharp car. Here, we'll take a peek inside. And it looks like it's had an older restoration done on the interior. It's two-tone, sort of a, you know, creamy white and black. It's got a 50-50 split back bench seat in it. It looks nice and comfortable for sure. It does have a later model steering column in it. It looks like it came out of a Cadillac. And they've added some aftermarket gauges with a tack on the side of the column there. It does still have the original speedometer, 100 mile per hour speedometer, as well as the clock over there on the passenger side. And it has the faux wood grain dash. I mean, it's not like it's a 100 point show car or anything, but it's a really nice driver for sure. And of course the rear seat matches the front. Even has the built-in armrest there. I mean, it's looking pretty sharp. Here, we'll continue on out back. It's got a pretty sleek shape to it, too. Very nice. Chrome bumper at the back here, too. And it does have dual exhaust with chrome tips. And I would guess a 10-bolt rear out back, but I haven't crawled under there to see it yet. They've also added some LED tail lights. I like those just for the mere fact that if you burn out a bulb or two of the LEDs, you know, they're still functional. So it's a nice little upgrade. That's a pretty smooth car. I believe it's got a small block Chevy under the hood. Let's go ahead and pop it open and take a look. Alright, it's looking pretty nice under here as well. One thing, it needs a prop rod, and if it has one on here, I'm sure not seeing it. I mean, maybe I'm an idiot, but I don't see it anywhere, so I'm going to have to actually hold it up with my left hand while I show you the engine here. But pretty nice looking small block Chevy in here. It's got those Edelbrock Elite valve covers. It does have a pair of dual quads up top, that's cool. Looking pretty sharp. Nice long tube headers on there with an XL super coil on the firewall. You can see they've got a sheet of metal for the firewall, so it's all smooth and everything. But pretty nice setup. Then they've added an aluminum radiator as well, which is always a good idea. Like I said, looks like a nice solid driver. It does have the dual master cylinder. You know, it's all been upgraded. Probably got some disc brakes up front. Haven't looked real close yet. In fact, let's see if we can look through the wheels here. Yeah, it does. I don't know if you guys can make that out, but it does have some disc brakes up front here. That'd be a fun, you know, weekend cruiser for sure. Pretty sharp. Let's go ahead and check out the specs on it. Once again, it's a 1947 Chevrolet two-door sedan. It's been shaved, you know, all the most of the emblems anyway. But I say it runs and drives good. It would definitely cost you a lot more money to put something together like that. And, it looks like it's ready to go. Well, anyway, guys, hope you like taking a look at that one. As always, we do appreciate you watching and commenting and everything. And we'll see you in the next one. Bye.